Hey everybody, Jason, Kentucky Fried Ham, back at US 3786 Waveland State Historic Site today. I had some errands to run and wanted to go to a park. Wasn't really sure where I wanted to start, so I was kind of halfway between Fort Harrod and here, and I just kind of punched them both into Google Maps and saw which one was going to be closer. So I'm here at Waveland. I don't know what I'm going to do yet. I just brought my TR-35 because I ran into the house without everything else. So I've got that. I also have my woofer coil and my end-fed random wire like I used last time here. So I'm going to decide what antenna I want to use today, and then I'm going to get on the air, and I'll be back with you. All right, guys. So I'm set up. I decided to use my woofer coil. No particular reason. But the ground is kind of hard. We haven't had rain in a while, and so it was a little bit rough. But this is... You may have seen my previous build video where I just did a quick build with this little single lever paddle. I'm going to try to use it today. This is probably going to go absolutely terribly, but we're going to give it a shot and see if we can make it work. So let's go. Oops. Whoa, 27 words a minute. That's not right. Let's go to 17. I've heard quite a few signals on 17, so I'm hoping today that this will actually work out. Also made the K6ARK iambic paddles. I might give those a try later. Like I said, I've been interested in trying a single lever or a cootie lately, so I printed this because it's a really cheap way to test it out. Thank you.
I have no idea how much power I'm actually putting out here or if my battery's even good. I've used this talent cell a couple of times, and I think I mentioned it before, I need to tune the low battery light on this. I also need to make a mod so this is mono by default when you build it. So I'm only really getting one channel of audio out, but there's a mod you can make to get left and right both. It's still mono, but at least you get both channels. So I'm going to do that, and then when I have it opened up, I'll just play with the battery voltages as well. Tune around here a little bit, see if I still hear any of those other stations. There's somebody on 7-8, which I'm not hearing now. Sounds like the band might have died. There was about 5 stations I heard when I was looking for a frequency. But let's go ahead and move down to 20. Sounds like 30 is definitely doing good. All right, let me go add some length here. It's usually dead on with these knots, but let's just do the smart thing and just make sure that we're looking good here. .1406, so I'm too short. Glad I checked it. Still need to lengthen a little bit. Like I said, the ground is really dry right now, so ground conductivity is going to be different than what I'm usually using. There we go, 1-to-1. Beautiful. Right at 1406. In here. Is it? Oh. Great signal. Get a good CQ here. So this is actually 5 contacts, because before I came in here this morning, or this afternoon, I was talking to some guys on the repeater, and I said, hey, I'm getting ready to do a POTA, so let's jump over to Simplex. And so I got 3. Actually, it was just one guy I was expecting, and 2 more guys came back to me, so I've already got 5 out of the 10 I need. He faded way down there. All right, let's see if I can successfully send my call again. Thank you. What's up for? So this isn't going as bad as I thought. I had the opportunity to buy a Bugatti Simplex Mono through a guy at the club, and I didn't because I kept trying and just could not send anything on it. So I passed on it. I wish I hadn't now because, of course, all it takes is just a little bit of practice. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So one more for a successful activation. Something five in there. It might have faded out. There's quite a bit of QSB, but I'm glad the bands are in good shape tonight. I looked at the band conditions before I left, which I usually don't, and it's saying basically tonight all the way from pretty much all the high bands are good, and the low bands are kind of fair. Thank you. I think there was somebody else there. Yeah, but even the last few days, we haven't had any, I don't think we've had any major solar flares or anything, but the bands have still been kind of wonky. But today, it's looking pretty nice and quiet. I think I've actually got my activation right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 plus 3. So I'd like to get them all CW too, but I'm in good shape. The rest of it's just icing on the cake. It's been a very long, stressful couple weeks. Our air conditioning saga, which I won't bore you with, but it's nice to be. It's finally Friday. I think everything's resolved. It's a beautiful night out. It's nice just to get out and get on the air. I'm also excited today. Yaesu announced a new QRP rig to compete with the IC705. It's kind of their version of the IC705, all band, all mode, 6 watts with an internal battery, all SDR. So I'll be interested to see, it comes out in 2025. It'll be interesting to see what the price on that guy is. I've been thinking about trying to start saving for 705, but I'm a Yaesu man, so I might have to just wait out a little bit. The new MTR-3B is also coming out later this year, so got to keep that in mind as well. Excited to see what they're doing there.
Hey, want to hear the most annoying sound in the world?
All right. Well, yeah. Let's see what's going on here. This mate's tuning up to work me or just trying to be annoying. Thank you. I was gonna move, but now that I got a contact, I gotta stay here a little bit longer. See if there's anybody else out there. I'm going to go try some 30 meters. All right, so let me go add the coil in and extend this whip out here. This is the hardest part of tuning this antenna. The coil is not an exact science. I do have it marked so that hopefully it's pretty easy to tune. Got this coil, I think I've mentioned before when I bought it, they said with this combination it would only do 60 in the upper part of 80, but I can get it to tune all the way to the bottom of 80 with no issues. I've never tried it actually. Yeah, my QOX would actually do, that's a weird looking signal there, but I'm a little bit long, so I'm actually going to maybe try to just shorten this whip a little bit rather than mess with the coil. See if that helped at all. Looks pretty good. 1.2. See if you can see that there. Well, there's signals. Really loud signals here. Thank you. I think it is now a new UTC day. So, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I got 10 CW and 3 sideband yesterday. So now we're working on day number 2. So I now need to get another 10 at least. Starting to get hungry. I think I'm going to go down to 40 meters. Yeah, I think I'll go down to 40 so I can try to get my next 6 contacts here, but my stomach's starting to grumble. Got Manwich waiting at home, which must mean one thing, and that is that my wife is having shrimp. I'm allergic to seafood, so whenever she has shrimp, she makes me Manwich, which is nice. So at 7030, the call-in frequency, we're at 1.5. 1.4. I'm gonna shorten this whip up a little bit. I find it easier than messing with the coil. I've got, like I said, a couple marks on the coil for the different bands. But if they need a little bit of a touch up, I think it's easier just to shorten the whip if you can. If it's, you need to lengthen it, obviously that's a problem. Down here too. It's not as bad though. Come on, baby, I need 6 more for this second day activation here. Missouri. Yep, thanks, Steve. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. One more. Well, I got my 10 anyway. All right, one last call, then I'm gonna go because it's getting dark and I'm gonna lose something when I pack up and I'm really hungry. Well, there we go. So I believe if my time is right, that's two activations. One yesterday on the 23rd, I believe, and one today on the 24th, which is a new UTC day. So I did get enough both times in the log for a complete activation. I wanted to make sure of that. I don't come out around this time very often, so it's nice to get the UTC change over there. And the band conditions were really good. I mean, there was some noise and you know, it was a little up and down at times, but all in all, it was a good night. I was only out here for about an hour and 10 minutes or so and made probably 30 contacts. I call that a good night. But on that note, I'm going to go home and spend the night with my family and watch some TV and have some Manwich and probably some brownies and enjoy the rest of the evening. And hope you do the same. And until next time, 73.